planning regards to procedure and behaviour and ethics. Welcome to this evening's committee of the Licensing Committee. I received apologies from Councillors Hodgson, who is the chair of the Licensing and that committee. My name is Councillor Steve Benison, and as vice chair, I am chair this meeting today in his absence. Apologies for absence have also been received by Councillors Mary Jordan and Richie Pitt. Is there any other apologies before we go further? Declarations of interest. Do any members have any interests or respect to any item on the agenda this evening? Okay, take that as a no. We move on to the minutes. And to approve the minutes and accuracy of the minutes of the meeting held on the 16th of November 2022. Can we take that as approved? Next is the minutes of the licensing panel. To approve the accuracy and the minutes of the licensing panel, now renamed as the licensing subcommittee, meetings held on the 19th of December 2022, the 20th of December 2022, the 6th of January 2023, and the 18th of January 2023. Can we take them as correct and agreed? And we move on to item number four, which is public members and questions. No questions from members or any statements or petitions have been received, but there has been a question from a member of public. Mr. Grace? Yeah.
Which microphone will be best?
Just come forward and see any of those microphones there.
Working days after that, depending on
terms of reference, obviously been approved previously by council, so this is why the recommendation is to note this. The further recommendation is in relation to allowing a delegated authority to be given to the Director of Law and Governance, monitoring officer in consultation with the chair and spokespersons, to convene Licensing Act subcommittees as and when required for the purposes of carrying out the council's functions under statutory delegation, to deal with applications, determinations and reviews of licences, as well as permissions, which would relate to the temporary rent notices, and any related matter in respect of the Licensing Act 2003 or the Gambling Act of 2005. Authority is also given for perhaps to two further members of the Licensing Act Committee who can attend such hearings as observers as part of the ongoing training programme. Members will also be aware from the report that it's recommended for the membership of the Licensing Act Committee to continue until such time as a new Licensing Act Committee be appointed. And this will allow subcommittees to hear applications which may have to be heard at short notice, and ensures that the hearing, those attending the